Alright, YouTubers, welcome back to War Thunder Ground Forces with the Angry Nerd. And today I thought we would take a look at the prototype KV-220. Now, this is one of the reward vehicles for the summer event, and I thought I would let you take a look at it and actually see it in action, see if it's something that you really want to grind for. Now, the KV tanks were a series of Soviet heavy tanks named after the Soviet defense commissar and politician Clement Vorosilov, developed before the war and used by the Red Army during the war. The KV series were known for their very heavy armor protection during the early part of the war, especially during the first years of the German invasion of the Soviet Union. The KV tanks were practically immune to the 37mm and howitzer-like short-barreled 75mm guns that were mounted on the early Panzer III's and Panzer IV tanks fielded by the invading German forces until more effective guns were developed. By 1942, the Germans were fielding a large number of long-barreled 50mm and 75mm guns, and the KV's armor was no longer invincible. The KV-1's 76.2mm gun also came under criticism. While adequate against most German tanks, it was the same gun carried by the smaller, faster, and cheaper T-34 medium tank. In 1943, it was determined that this gun could not penetrate the frontal armor of the new Tiger. Even before the outbreak of World War II, the Soviets were already looking to improve the KV series of tanks. The KV-220 prototype, also known as the KV-220-2, the T-220, Object 220, or just 220 in factory documents, was a heavy experimental tank built on the chassis of a KV with reinforced armor and a very powerful armament for its time. The considerably buffed up hull housed a new turret, which was developed specifically for the long-barreled F-30 85mm gun. In comparison to early tanks of the KV series, this tank was much heavier. Therefore, its chassis was lengthened to add an additional road wheel. Armor was increased to 100mm thick, and in order to counter the loss of maneuverability, a new 4-stroke 12-cylinder V5 prototype engine with 700 horsepower was installed, instead of the V2K engine with 500 horsepower. Later, this engine was changed to the V2SN with 850 horsepower. The KV-220 did not meet the Army's expectations, and only one was built for testing in the process of developing the future KV-3, 4, or 5s as the Red Army's heavy tank for the years to come. However, with the outbreak of the war, dreams of a shiny new KV tank vanished. As the Germans neared Moscow and Leningrad, everything with a gun was thrown into battle. Many prototypes and canceled vehicles defended their factories at Leningrad. The KV would be no different. The KV-220's turret defended the city separately from its hull, taking its place in a gun battery. The tank hull itself was fitted with a KV-1 turret armed with a 76mm F-32 gun and fought with the 124th Tank Brigade. This heavy tank was almost invincible at the time and fought for a couple of months before it was destroyed by a direct hit from a German 150mm howitzer in December of 1941. Now, in War Thunder, the KV-220 is a rank 3 with a battle rating of 5.3. It has a 1,351 horsepower engine, propelling the 62.7-ton vehicle to a top speed of 22.7 miles per hour. It comes equipped with the 85mm F-30 cannon. Now I have it assigned to an expert crew with a crew level of 140, which gives me a reload of 7.9 seconds. Now below, you can see the XP and Silver Line rewards. I'm not going to break it down for you, but it's basically a XP reward of 498% and a Silver Line reward of 300%. But if I'm not mistaken, I believe I'm getting an extra bonus for the premium account. So what do I think of the KV-220 here in War Thunder? Well, I really like it. It has some extra armor on the hull. And if you take a look at the front of the turret, it has a nice thick gun mantlet. And they did away with a lot of the flat on the front of the turret. The sides of the turret slope in nicely toward that gun mantlet. And this thing can really take some punishment. Now, if it gets hit directly above or below the gun itself on the flat part of that mantlet, it can get penetrated by vehicles at this tier. But I have faced off against Tiger IIs, IS-1s, even an IS-2, and taken some hits on the turret and not died. It is a very bouncy turret. So I'm thinking that you will probably like this thing too. That being said, we have a couple of different looks at the KV-220 today. One on White Rock Fortress, where I was kind of forced to go up into the fortress where the cap is just to have something to shoot at. And another on Tunisia, where I was able to employ this excellent gun in a long-range sniping role for a while. So, here we go. KV-220. Okay, it looks like we picked up a White Rock Fortress. So, yeah, and it looks like the cap point is in the center of the fortress there. I'm gonna choose this lower spawn point. It's not going to make that much of a difference, but I just think the route to the actual fortress is quicker this way. It has a hole in the side of the wall on this side that I think I can get to quicker. But first we have to cross this crappy terrain, which is slow for almost every vehicle I've ever brought up through here, and the KV-220 is no exception there. So yeah, but overall the vehicle seems to move fairly well. Got a T-34/85 D5T passing me, but hey, he's really maneuverable. And to tell you the truth, this doesn't feel too bad. I'm at 22 miles an hour coming through here right now, so feels pretty good. Oh, what is that? Panzer IV? Oh, and he hit me in the track. And I missed him. So, anyway, he's gone to hide. I need to keep moving. So I want to get up here before the enemy establishes, and there's some fire coming from over here to my left. Now what is this? Missed it. Alright, so let's keep moving. More fire coming. Need to make it through here with a purpose. So I'm gonna get tagged. Yep. Ah. And I ran into the wall. Okay, so I'm looking at the minimap. I don't see any real red up in here right now, so I'm going to try to come through this section through here and see if I can get some sneaky fire on. Well, if I can not run into crap, get some sneaky fire on some of these vehicles up through here. Let's see. Oh yeah. There we go. And what's behind him? Reload. Oh, I think he's dead. And I've got artillery fire coming, so. Alright, we're gonna move. Going to move. What is that? Panther? Panthers are pretty deadly. It's already coming in on my position. And make sure I don't get popped when I try to come through here from the left here. Oh, what is that? M4? Oh, you bounce. Have some 85 millimeter. There you go. That was just for you. Oh, KV-2. Some for you too. There you go. And the Panther's up there. Don't really have a shot on him. I need to be careful. Anything comes out through here. What do we got? Oh, shoot. Lucky he didn't catch me in the side. Come on, turn around, turn around. Let's get him in the side. Or through the front. There we go. And let's get this gun down. Some gun depression. Let's get it down. Come on. Come on. It was a nice hit, but didn't kill him. Let's move. Okay, he's dead. Okay. Oh, what is that? There we go. Woo! That was amazing. What else is over here? Oh, shoot. But looks like my crew is still good. So I'm okay right this minute. Don't see anything coming down the road. So I think we're gonna be fine. All right. Just burning a little bit. Roast some hot dogs or s'mores on that hole there. Okay, I did see something at the end of the bridge, so I'm gonna come around here and see if I can get in a position to engage them when they come through. All right, this should do. Well, I thought I saw something coming. Okay, I guess he's not coming, but I see something on the mini-map over here to my left trying to come. It looks like he's on the outside of the fortress, so let's go see if we can see him through here. Oh! Yes, we can. Okay, he hit us but didn't do much, and we killed a lot of his crew. He's probably on crew replacement. And, yep. So there was nobody there to kill. Let's try right here. There we go. Okay, so that worked out okay. And I ran into something else. What is up with me driving today? All right. And a friendly KV-2 there. He's just waiting for somebody to pop out. Oh! Shoot. Let's see. Oh, that didn't go through and hit him. Must have hit like a hatch or something. Come on. He took out the KV-2. All right, we got his engine. Hit him through the turret. And he's moving again so soon. Okay. Well, there we go. Okay, we weren't able to save that KV-2, but that dude came through there with a quickness and got behind the hull of that Sherman. Oh, there we go. That's what I was expecting to do to him. Like a tank graveyard over there. And actually, I think I did all three of those. Anybody else gonna come through there? I got an IS-1 heading over. Wouldn't do it, dude. Would not pull out there. And he got hit, but doesn't look like he's too much worse for wear, so. Looks like he's gonna hold this spot down. Let's just see. Let's move. Redundant to sit there. I'm gonna go and look. We got something happening on the other side of the fortress here. You can see some red and close to the gap over here. So I don't know what just happened with the volume. All right, I see something. There we go. Oh, bounced. Did absolutely nothing. Don't know what hit me there. Oh, he hit me again, but then nothing hit off my nice turret. Here we go. Booyah! There you go. Okay, got something here to the middle. Oh, a KV-2 up there. And a Tiger H-1. There you go. Right through the turret face. Okay, so KV-2, be careful. Bam! I think he fired. Here's the KV-2. I'm gonna rush him. He's got a long reload. Let's see how this does. Here we go. Come on, where you at? Oh! It was a ZIS-6! Dang it! Man! So yeah, I ended up destroying 9 vehicles with the KV-2 in that match. My second vehicle, I got sniped as I was on my way to the fortress. And the third vehicle, I got bombed or rocketed as I was leaving the spawn. So there was a lot of just watching the other players. I decided to cut that out to shorten the overall length of this video. So yeah, let's take a look at the second match in Tunisia. Here we go. Okay, looks like we picked up Tunisia. And we are on the northern side of the map, it looks like. I don't have a good desert camouflage to switch to. Let's take this westernmost spawn point here. So just use the regular camouflage, the quickie camouflage that I made. All right, we are gonna head straight forward to this rocky outcropping in front of me, and let's see if we can get some shots on some vehicles heading over toward B. Now if C starts getting captured, I might need to worry about that, but I'm not going to worry about it until it starts getting captured. But we've got a couple of friendlies who spawned in behind me or who are heading over that way. Okay, is this going to be our first victim? Oh, no, I can't get anything really lined up. Can't see an outline. Got something coming right there. I am having a gun depression issue. That's as far down as I could get it. I couldn't go down and just gonna snap that shot at him, but I couldn't depress the gun any further. So, yeah. Let's see if I can hit this. I hit him. Killed his loader. Oh, Sherman Firefly over there, but he's hidden again. Cannot get the gun down to him. Let's see about this guy. Can't get a bead on him either. Can I, how about this guy here? He's shooting at me. No. Come on. Oh, something hit me. No damage. Let's see if I back up. Can I get a bead? Oh, it's that Sherman Firefly with the 17 pounder has hit me twice for no damage. Yep, nothing. I really can't get a good bead on him. Okay, he hit me again. Minor damage. This thing has a very, very good turret. Let's see. It's well, sides are well angled, a nice gun mantlet. If he hits me right above or below the gun, I might be in trouble. But yeah. I'm reluctant to just sit here and take the punishment when I can't give any out, so we're gonna move. Even though it was not major damage, he might could get a shot that hit me just right. So we're just gonna reposition. Let's see if I can administer some pain over this way. Oh, who is this? Don't really have a great shot, but oh yes, there we go. Didn't really have a green marker that I could tell, but then again, I don't see very well. Sometimes I shoot a rock and think I'm hitting something. I don't want to get out there too far and have my hull exposed. But there is this rock right over there. Maybe I can go over there, get my hull down behind the rock, and have my turret out to engage some of these targets. Let's give that a try. What's that? M4? There we go. Across the map. Miss. See if I can readjust a little bit. I don't know. Let's try it. Yes. There we go. I don't see anything right this second. I have air battle as an option, and I really don't see anything to shoot at. Take it. Air battle. But alright, let's go hide. Get behind this big old rock. Come on, come on. Here we go, here we go. Yes. Okay. LA-5 coming in. What to go for? this, and maybe this, and maybe in front of this guy. We got one more. Let's see. There we go. I doubt those will do anything. I'm not really good at bombing. It's just hard to get home point with the joystick. Did get a little hit from one. And a kill assist. Alright. Get over here behind this rock again. See what we can do. What is that? And that is moving too fast for me. Oh. We got a hit. And he moved. Oh. M18, be still, M18. Okay. Pull forward just a little bit. Oh. Let's go. Nope. Couldn't really tell. I was just guessing. Okay. That'll work. Alright, what is this? Come on out. Come on out. Oh, we bounced it off the track. He shot at me. I think I tracked him, so this next one should be alright. Here we go. Come on. There we go. And are you gonna stay there after your friend just got obliterated? Oh, I think somebody killed him right before I could hit him. All right. Well, really cannot see where to shoot this guy. Well, we hit him. See if we can adjust a little bit from that. Nope, he moved. All right, KV-85 is back. Well, someone's capturing C. Okay, so those IL-2s have rockets. They're kind of scary. Alright, where is the something over here? Ooh, bombs. Oh, there he is. Ba-bam. It's me over here. There you go. Alright. Let's cap this zone. Put this back in our hand. And we'll move off and find something else to do. Because I'm not just going to stay in here. Okay. mind, there's a lot of targets heading over toward B. See, I can get a bead on anybody. Yep. Ooh, this is a target-rich environment. Need to be careful not to expose myself to too many people at once. There we go. It's like shooting babies or something. Yes. Little ASU 57, it's like kicking puppies. It's so small. Alright, what do we got? Something down there behind that rock that I just cannot see. Something way up here, let's see. Oh, I just clipped him. He moved. Oh, I hit his gun barrel. He's called in artillery and he's hiding. I have taken numerous hits to this turret throughout this match. This guy's hiding very well. But I want to go and deal with this person down by that rock, but that 3485 will have good shots on me if I try to do it. Huh. What to do? I think I might go for it. Alright, let's make a break. Make a break for it. Here we go. I'm not sure what's down here, but we're gonna come down here and find out. T-3485 might still get shot on me. Oh, he tracked me. Alright. Here you go. There you go. Now what is this? Oh. Alright. I'm gonna be reloaded in just a second and you're not gonna like it. All right, bye-bye. There we go. 15 seconds on the track, but they did kill a lot of my crew members. I think I was taking hits from this T-3485 up here, and I think it was creating just a nice flat spot on the side of my turret for him to shoot at. They've got C back. So I might need to do something about that, but I need to. I'm worried about this T-34 having a good shot on me, so. Alright, but we're gonna do it anyway. We got no friendlies over there. I think I'll be alright. Nothing to shoot at over there but that T-34, and he's been hiding from me, so maybe I can find something down here. I I like the damage to the fender. I just noticed that. That's pretty cool damage there. This thing is rolling pretty well in the sand. Uh-oh, air attack. 22 miles an hour. Okay, my teammates are taking back A, it looks like. I'm going to come take back C. Yep, oh, that's it. Stick a fork in her. She's done. Not bad. Okay, let's see what we did. Second place in the team, huh? Alright, Sniper, Avenger, Multi-Strike, Professional, Shadow Strike Streak, One Shot, 11 ground units destroyed, 3 assist, not bad, second place in the team, 97,591. We are running a Silver Lion booster and premium account. Still, that's not bad. 11. Oh, this dude got 12. All right, let's save it. Okay. Okay, so yeah, I've got a couple of games in the KV-220 under my belt now, and I really like this vehicle. That sloping, or not sloping, the angling of the front of the turret that you can see here is really, really good. And it's 100 millimeters of thickness all the way around, if my memory serves me correctly. Now, there is another option, the KV-2 ZIS-6, and if I had to choose between the two for purchasing with my money, I would probably go with the KV-2 ZIS-6, but the KV-220 is a really good alternative for that. And since you have the ability to grind during the summer event and get this vehicle for free, man, if I had the time to do that and it wasn't provided for me, I would be all over it, because this is a good vehicle. Now, like I said, I didn't have time, don't have time to grind for this event with a full-time job. Gaijin was nice enough to let me get these two vehicles to review for you during the summer event, so thank you so much for that, Gaijin. And if you have liked this review, hit that like button. If you didn't, don't. Subscribe if you would. But as always, thanks for watching. I really appreciate it. Nerd out.